Hallelujah. Oh, bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Come on, somebody, bless the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah, Jesus. It's another day's journey, and I'm glad, glad about it. Glad, I'm glad about it. Glad, I'm glad. It's another day's journey, and I'm glad. Oh, I'm so glad to be here. Well, you gave me health and strength, and I'm glad. I'm glad. I'm glad. Oh, I'm glad. Lord, you gave me health and strength, and I'm glad. Oh, I'm so glad to be here. Oh, you gave me food and shelter, and I'm glad. I'm glad. I'm glad. Oh, you gave me food and shelter, and I'm glad. Oh, I'm so glad to be here. Yeah, it's another day's journey. I'm glad. I'm glad. I'm glad. It's another day's journey. I'm glad. Oh, I'm so glad to be here. Hallelujah. Well, bless the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Did someone get a scripture? Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. We're going to have a reading of the scripture, and then I'll offer a prayer, and we'll go ahead and get started. Guys, welcome to Wednesday night Bible study at the Ark of Jesus Ministries right here at Wynn Road North, 1000 Wynn Road North.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. You want to put your, come on right over here in front of the camera and see yourself there. Go right ahead.
I have the 23rd Psalm.
Yes.
And it says, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pasture.
Yes.
He leadeth me beside the still water.
Yes.
He restores my soul.
Hallelujah.
He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake.
Mm-hmm.
Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil.
Mm-hmm.
For thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies.
Yes, yes.
Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over.
Yes.
Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life.
Yes.
And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Amen, amen, amen. Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus, we bless you tonight. We thank you, Lord. We just give you all the praise. We give you all the honor. And we give you all the glory, Lord God, that we are able to do, Father God. We come, Lord God, loving you with our heart, with our soul, with our mind, and with our strength. Oh God, bless this Bible study tonight. Lord, let us leave, Lord God, build up, encouraged in you. Holy Spirit, come in and just have your way. Move mightily, Lord God. Lord God, even in the social media arena, Lord God, move mightily. We give you praise in Jesus' name. Somebody say amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. If sister was here, she'd sing, victory is mine. Victory is mine. Victory today is mine. Oh, I told Satan, come on. Get thee, oh, victory today is mine. Oh, say, victory is mine. Victory, victory is mine. Oh, victory today
is mine.
Got the victory.
Victory.
Yeah.
Get.
I knew that the Lord would bring me out. Oh, got down on my knees. Say, Lord, help me, please. When I rose, I had the victory. Oh, sing it. Thank God for those old warriors from time past with those songs. Dorothy Norwood and Shirley Caesar and all those guys. Amen? I mean, those songs brought us over. Is that all right? Amen. I love those old songs. Hallelujah. Well, again, welcome. This is Ark of Jesus Ministries. The angel of this house is Bishop David J. Singleton and Lady Dawn Singleton. Amen. We thank God for them. We bless God for them tonight. I'm thankful that he allows me to come in and do this Wednesday night Bible study. He doesn't have to, but he does, and I give God praise for that. It's an honor all by itself. And we are continuing with our D's, and we're on declare. Somebody say declare.
Declare.
We're doing declarations. I hope you got some together tonight because we're doing some declarations. That's what we're doing. But let's talk a little bit about declare. And I actually went over, which I won't, we'll really kind of tear that one apart in the next one because it is different on our decree. I went over and got some notes on that, but I don't want to so much get into that tonight. I want to deal with declarations. Declarations, declaring. The root word is declare, but it's declarations. So what is that? The biblical declarations are, it's a way to speak God's word over yourself. It's a way to speak what?
God's word over yourself.
I wrote a song that says, speak life over yourself. Speak it over yourself. Now, that wasn't proper English, but that's what I wanted to say. Speak life over yourself. You see what I'm saying? Yeah, I got to speak it over myself. Is that right? I'm talking about me now. Say myself. Is that all right? Myself. And then you can move it forward. And after that, you can take it on then to where? Your children and... You know, you understand, you can move it on then after that, is that all right? Mm-hmm. But you want to be able to speak the word of God over your what?
Self.
Amen. Make it personal, you say over me, myself, out of my mouth, what am I saying? Is that all right?
Amen.
All right. Declarations can have Many benefits, all right? Mm-hmm. So our base scripture tonight, everybody probably already know it, is going to be Romans 10:17. Y'all already know it. And we'll probably be throwing in some more, but that's going to be our base scripture tonight. Because we're talking about speaking. Is that all right?
Amen.
We're talking about speaking and the importance of speaking. How many people know it's very important how we speak?
Yes, it is.
It matters how we speak.
Yes.
It matters what we speak. It matters when we speak. Am I talking right?
Amen.
It matters where we speak. And guess what else? It matters how we speak. All of them apply. Is that right?
Mm-hmm.
We can hear and why. We can hear why we speak. It all goes there. Mm-hmm. It all goes there. Amen.
Amen.
So as we're talking about declarations, speaking God's word over yourself. Mm-hmm. Number one, and I'm going to give you seven points that we're going to cover before we start declaring on some benefits of declarations, how they can benefit us. All right? Okay. So number one is building faith. Building faith. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Declarations help to what? Build our faith. Uh-huh. Can anybody see how that can work?
Mm-hmm.
Building faith. Okay? Speaking biblical declarations can help you grow your faith in God. So go ahead, whoever has it now, and read our base scripture for tonight.
It's for with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation.
Is that the one?
Oh, wait a minute. You said Romans 10:17.
Yeah.
That was 10:10. I'm sorry.
Hey.
So then faith cometh by hearing.
Uh-huh.
And hearing by the word.
Now we're talking. Now we're talking. But the one you read wasn't a bad scripture.
No, it wasn't.
You know what I mean? I mean, there are no bad scriptures, huh?
Yeah.
Go back and read the one you read, 10:10.
For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness.
Uh-huh.
And with the mouth confession is made unto salvation.
Yeah, for with the heart man has faith to get righteousness. Mm-hmm. And with the mouth, he says that Jesus is Lord to get salvation.
Mm-hmm.
Amen? So that's all in declaration right there. He's declaring something when he's declaring Jesus is Lord. Right?
Yes.
Is that right?
Yes.
We're declaring something right there. That's a declaration all by itself. Jesus is Lord. If you're declaring it over yourself, right?
Mm-hmm.
If you're saying Jesus is your Lord, is that right?
That's right.
Amen. You're declaring something. That's a declaration right there. But where we were headed was to 17, because we're talking about speaking tonight.
Mm-hmm.
We're talking about actually saying it out loud. And so the Romans 10:17 says what? We build up our faith, because we say, number one, it helps us, declaration, speaking out loud, helps us to do what? Build our faith. And so the scripture says, so faith comes by hearing and hearing by the word of God. Is that all right?
Mm-hmm.
So what happens when we speak that can cause us to build our faith? It's real simple. Come on. Excuse me. What can do that? It's real simple. Think about it.
Belief.
Belief happens. But we're saying, so faith comes by hearing. But you know something, I like to, with me on that scripture, I like to stop. I like to stop right there where that comma is. I like to pause for a minute. Faith comes by hearing. It literally, look at me for a minute. It can be hearing anything.
Yes.
You say, oh.
Yeah. You hear a lot.
Oh, no, what, really? Think about it.
Mm-hmm.
Think about it. There's a lot of things you heard in your life was not scripture.
That's true.
Am I talking right?
Mm-hmm.
And you build faith in it.
Yeah.
You did it, or you believed it, or whatever the case may be. You understand what I'm trying to say? I don't care if you were sitting in a classroom on a teacher.
Mm-hmm.
She wasn't teaching out of the Bible.
Yeah.
Unless you were in Bible school.
Mm-hmm.
Am I talking right?
Yeah.
She's doing an algebra thing on the board up there, or some geometry or division. Or something else. But how did you get faith in that thing? You kept hearing it over and over and over.
It was explained.
It was explained, but even when somebody explained it, you got to hear it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's my point.
Yeah.
The only time you're not hearing it is you deaf.
Mm-hmm.
And by that time, they're using what? Sign language. Am I talking right?
Yeah.
Anybody understand what I'm saying right now?
Yeah.
There are songs that you can, you now maybe just me, but there are songs that you can hear. They can be worldly songs.
Mm-hmm.
And you can hear them over and over and over and over.
Stuck in your head.
And it'll get stuck in your head. And you will have to do something to get it out.
Mm-hmm.
And you're a Christian.
Mm-hmm.
And you can hear a song from back in the day. Pour that song and it'll be going over and over and over. I know what I'm talking about.
Mm-hmm.
And you're going to have to counteract it with something else. Why? You build up a hearing, a faith in that thing from hearing it over and over and over. You can even hear a song that you don't like. And you just keep hearing it over and over. And after a while, you will get the jingle. Am I talking right? Before you know it, you'll have that. You'll be talking about, why that thing I keep saying that? Where did that come from, right? Why am I saying this? Where did I learn that at? Yeah. You think about babies. Think about babies. Bishop, like, we use children, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay? How do they learn some of the things that they are saying? What? How you think they're hearing it? They might not be hearing the word of God, but they're hearing it. Some of them can come up and give you some cuss words. You understand? Yeah. Some of them come up and tell you some stuff. Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. Had a little girl in one of my classes. She was coming in a little something. She's running around there talking about something was making her weak in the knees. Now, where did she get that from?
Exactly.
And I'm like saying, baby, what are you listening to? What kind of music you hearing? Right? But it has been because of what she was hearing. You see what I'm saying? Yeah, yeah. So my point is, and thank you, Lord, right on this point, even though in the proverb, we have to guard our hearing. The Bible says we have to set a guard at our ears. Is that right? How many people know that's a gate? That's a gate. So we got an eye gate. Yeah. You have the ear gate. Right? So things come in. Right? So we have to set a guard there because faith comes by hearing, and we can be hearing the wrong thing. But what the scripture is telling us tonight is hearing the word of God. That's what we want to focus tonight, because we want to build our faith up where? In God. Not just build up faith, but we want to build up faith in God. You see? There's a lot of things that I'm telling you that are getting built up out there today in the world. People are hearing a lot of stuff. They're hearing a lot of stuff. And I don't even want to repeat over half of it, but I'm just saying they're hearing. But we have to guard our ear gate. So number one, declarations then, what we say out of our mouths then, is, and it don't always have to be scripture.
Come on.
It can be something. It can be positive. It can be a positive quote. It can be a good word. It can be something that will build up and encourage. You understand what I'm trying to say? You might not be able to find a literal scripture that say that, but if it's building up the kingdom or if it's building up somebody, then it's a good thing, because the Bible says all good things come from God. Amen?
Amen.
All right. So Romans 10:17 is saying faith then comes by hearing. So as we hear things, we build up our faith. So we got to guard what we hear. And hearing then is through or by the word of God. Amen? Now, number two, reminding you of God's promises. Declarations remind us of what?
God's promises.
So the more we talk about it, and the more we say them, amen, it gets into us. And we're going to need that, because we're going through trials and tribulations. We need, amen? In other words, we're not always going to have a tablet or a phone or a hard copy or something with us. We're not going to always have it. It'll be nice. But then even when you have it with you, how do you know that in that time you're going to have time to look it up? You're going to have time to pull it out. You're going to have time to find the book. You're going to have time. Let me tell you, I was attacked by a demonic force years ago when I first gave my life to the Lord. And I didn't know what it was. I was a baby Christian. And I felt like something was oppressing me, holding me down. You know, like I couldn't get up. And I was like, oh, you know, and I'm trying to quote scripture and say stuff and carry on. And finally got, so I went to the leaders. I said, talk to the leaders. I said, what in the world is going on? I felt so strange. He said, let me tell you something. He said, oh, the next time any attack come upon you, you don't need to worry about looking up scripture. All you need to do is call on the name of Jesus.
I'm telling you,
deliverance comes.
Amen.
Deliverance comes. Mm-hmm. Sometimes you have to fight for it, but deliverance comes. I used to scare my mom sometime or my family sometime. I'd be in there struggling to go, Jesus! They go,
right.
Amen.
Sure it is.
Amen. Amen.
I
and that let us know. So when somebody say to you, oh, this Jesus, is it? No. Like I said, you know, it's too late to tell me that God doesn't work, that he's not real. You know what I'm trying to say? He doesn't heal. He doesn't deliver. Too late. Because I know the promises. I build up my faith. Amen? I've had some experiences with God. Is that all right?
better for yourself.
Yeah, yeah. So when you've had some experiences, then you do what to the one you know that you know that you know. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I can tell you that don't work with you. Like, oh, yeah, okay.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I know what God brought me. I know. You understand what I'm trying mm-hmm. to say. I can declare in the tree that he is real. Amen?
Amen.
So what? It reminds us of God's promises. Biblical declarations can remind us of God's promises to the children of God. I did a video on the covenant, five covenants of God, five covenants. And one that everybody knows was a rainbow. That was one of the ones. One of the ones is a rainbow, circumcision. We go down the line till we got, you know, till we end up at the Lord's Supper. But these are promises, right? So we know these promises. So the rainbow has been tried to be used by the devil to be turned into something that is not.
That is not.
But God, we know that God made that promise. That promise was to Noah. And what was it? I'm going to put the rainbow in the sky and let you know I will never destroy the world again by water. So what we have? We have tsunamis. We have floods. We have hurricanes. We have tornadoes. We have all kinds of water coming, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
But the world is not destroyed.
No.
Amen?
Amen.
The sea and the oceans doesn't overrun us.
But you know,
yes, come on.
We don't see the rainbow as often as we used to.
Well, I don't know. It might depend on your location and where you are. Yeah, because I've been seeing a couple lately. Yeah, you do. Yeah, you do. It depends on probably where you are in the location. And sometimes if you're in places that get a lot of rain, you know, and things
that's
of that sort.
We was getting out of rain.
Uh-huh.
I was looking for a rainbow.
Yeah.
I knew it was not going to be destroyed. But, you know, sometimes you just look for that sign.
But it's a beautiful sign to see it.
Yeah, it is.
I remember we did a trip up to Letchworth on one of my videos up in Letchworth. And as we were walking by the falls and different ones, and I looked around and I go, oh, there's a rainbow. And I went right over there and took a picture of it. It's a beautiful, you can't ever, every time you see it, it's just so, it's magnificent, you know? Yes, yes. But we know what it means because it was God's promise. So that, it builds up our faith every time we see it. That's what God said. Every time somebody gets circumcised, we ought to realize that's a covenant of God. That was a real, that was God's promise. Amen?
Yeah.
That was a promise of His.
Christ,
yes, yes, yes. So today, who is kids? Yes, that's right. We're children of God. That was an order He made.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Every time a baby's born, every time we do the Lord's Supper, amen?
Yes.
Or Eucharist, or you know, whatever you want to call it.
Circumcision.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Every time we do that, he said, do that in remembrance of me. Why, that's a promise of God to remind us of what? What he did for us. Is that right?
Mm-hmm.
And that we have everlasting life in him. Every time we do that. All right? What's another one? Helping you memorize scriptures. Somebody say helping you memorize scriptures.
Helping you memorize scriptures.
Excuse me, memorize. Memorize. Is it good to memorize?
Yes.
Yes, it is.
Why? Help me out here. Why is that?
Because it would help you to know his word better in your life. And you can believe on that and look to see the outcome of what his promise has in your life.
Amen.
And also, like you said, these books and things ain't going to be there available.
There you go.
Available to
there
us.
You go.
We're supposed to have it written on our heart.
There you go. Well, Lady Dawn often say that her father used to tell her, you know, you got to have the word in you because they're going to come and you won't have these Bibles.
Right.
You know, there are some countries you can't have them.
Right.
That's true.
You're not allowed to have that. You're not allowed to meet like this.
Mm.
And so we need to have the word in us. Amen?
Mm.
And the Lord said that if we put it in, the Holy Spirit will do what?
Bring it back
to our remembrance at the time of need. So we don't have to worry about, well, I know what to say or what to say or, you know, what to do at that time. Amen. Because the Holy Spirit lives in us and he said he'll bring it back to our remembrance. That's good.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. All right. So number, I hope y'all have your declaration. We're going to declare it. All right. So memorize scripture. Biblical declarations can help you memorize scriptures. Amen. Number four, helping you align your heart with God's will. How about that? How about helping us align? Get an alignment. Get an alignment with God. Right now, and I said I wasn't going to talk about this. I guess it's going to come in. Right now, no. Right now, I was watching a video on the way here. It's no secret because it's all out there. Of back in the day, they were having Bishop Carlton Pearson's funeral. Some of y'all might know who he was, who not. Yeah. Carlton Pearson.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. It was a video back from when they were doing this. A young man was making some points, and he was sharing this. And you had people there, Shirley Caesar, and a lot of folks was there, you know, at his funeral. And I'm talking about now alignment. I'm talking about alignment, aligning up with God's word. And on this particular video, if you see it, you can just pull it up. It has this bishop, and I forgot his name, but he was speaking, and he said that Bishop Carlton was his mentor. And what he did was introduced his husband. So as he was standing there and, you know, doing the introduction and all of what he was going to talk about and whatever he was going to say, and as if Bishop would then recognize Lady Dawn, he in turn then recognized his husband, who wouldn't be the first lady, be the first gentleman, this type of a thing. And so you can Google this. I'm not making this up. And so as he did that, Pastor Shirley, she didn't know what to do. You can see it right on the video. She almost jumped out of her seat, and then some other folks were there. But then, because there was a lot of people there, but the video didn't show them all. But you could see, you know, like how you have the pulpit and folks about and around. But you could see a lot of people there weren't in alignment. Because a lot of people there were clapping it on and they were okay with it. You understand what I'm trying to say? You see what I mean by alignment? So now what is it? Declarations that help us do what?
Remember.
Stay in alignment with the word of God. So what is that? We need to know what thus saith the Lord. Mm-hmm. Is that right?
Yes.
Because if we don't know what thus saith the Lord, then we won't be in alignment with God. Now what is happening right there? They in turn were bringing, they were trying to bring God. Yes, as the guy was saying it on. They were trying to bring God in alignment with them. You understand what I'm trying to say? Mm-hmm. You see, if we want to do something that is out of God's word, we can try to make God fit into our agenda. Does that make any sense to anybody?
Yes.
We want him to come into what we say or what we believe. Is that right? But that's not being what? In alignment with the word of God. Mm-hmm. We need to know what thus saith the Lord.
True.
See? Now, I don't know what happened afterwards. I think Bishop Shirley did a response to it later. Or somebody did something. I don't know because I didn't watch the whole video. It was a commentary showing parts, and it was commenting about it. But my point, I said all that to say, where we are in the world today, we got to know by us being able to declare the word of God, declare the promises of God, speak them so we build up our faith, and remind us of what God's promises are and what his word is. Because if we don't, and we can end up getting ourselves out of alignment, amen, and we'll end up yielding to the devil, thinking that we are exactly right. And we'll be off center. We'll be off course. Amen? Go ahead, sis, you had something?
Yeah, I was going to say the word tell us that straight and narrow is the way.
Is the way. And few there be that find it. And few there be that find it. But that gospel, I think, of Pastor Pearson was inclusion. His was inclusion. So, yeah. But I'm not on him. I just want to, you know, make that point. I happen to see that, and I said, wow. You know what I mean? Because how many, we have to think about that. Because if it happened here or somewhere else, how many of us going to be, well, bless the Lord. Amen. Glory be to God. You know, you see what I'm trying to say? You got to know where you are in God's word. We got to know that. See, and you won't have time to go looking in the Bible. What does the Bible say about this? What does the Bible say about that? We need to know what does saith the Lord. Yes.
You know, and Bishop told me that, like, with the class, and I was going to open up so anybody can pray. You know that.
Yes.
And he said, no, because we don't know everything.
Exactly.
Yeah. And so now it made me think, here they are sitting here, and for them, him to just put that out there on them.
Yes, and then everybody, they were okay. I mean, man, not all of them.
They were okay. It just, what could they do?
Well, like I say, I don't know. There could have, actually, there could have been a lot. Some could have, they could have got up, and, you know, nobody was holding them in the seat. They had a choice, they could have got up and left. Yeah. Sure, like I say, Pastor Shirley showed a really response. They, I don't know why the camera was on her, but she showed a really response, and I think she addressed it later. You could see in her action that she was totally disheveled, you know, with that. I don't say nobody was going to get up and attack somebody. That's not what it's about. But, you know, you got to know the word of God. And you, and what you would do in that time is when we get on discernment is the God, you know the word, but then the Holy Spirit will give you discernment on how to handle that situation, how to respond to that situation. Amen?
Yeah.
Amen. Yeah. Amen. Amen. Yeah. And just also know this too, that in the scripture, when we search it out, there were men of God that stood up for the word of God, and they weren't concerned about their life or anything else. Some of them, their life was taken. You know, we had with martyrs. Stephen was a martyr. Martyr for Christ, was stoned to death. Mm-hmm. Not that we want to do that, but you understand what I'm trying to say. Mm-hmm. If it comes to you standing up for what is right, for the word of God, you have to make a choice. You know what I mean? Sure. What am I going to do? Am I going to just deny Christ, or am I going to stand up for Christ? And what is happening here? Amen? Yeah, I pray we never deal with that, but the day will come. We need to know. Individually, you need to know.
Yeah.
Where are you staying? Are you at the place that you will take down and deny Christ here? Because the Bible says, and you can look this one up, if you deny me here, I'll deny you before the Father. That's what Jesus said.
And
yes. You have a word. Go ahead.
I agree with David. For me and my house.
Excuse me.
For me and my house, I will serve the Lord. For Christ I live.
Amen.
Christ I die.
Amen.
Come on.
And you have to know that. You have to know that. You know, so you want to declare. You want to declare. Now that's going to come when we get over in decree. But, you know, you're going to have to know where you stand.
That's right.
You know, I'll say this. There are other faiths. There are other faiths. Mm-hmm. Not Christian faith. There's other faiths.
Yes, yes.
They, in turn, is so convicted of their faith. Their convictions are so strong that that's why they'll kill themselves, even though they might be going in the wrong direction. But they totally believe so strongly in what they believe.
Yeah.
That they won't take down upon it. Mm-hmm. You understand? Mm-hmm. They're saying, no. This is what we believe. This is what our book teaches. This is what we stand upon. You understand what I'm trying to say?
And that's what they do in the
and they won't take down upon it.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying?
Yep.
But sometimes, you know, they look on Christians as this because Christians are standing or just whatever. You know, we'll just go for it. You understand what I'm trying to say? Well, I don't know. Well, I know it's not right, but still, you understand what I'm trying to say. So we have to know where we are in Christ. Am I telling you to go out and attack the world?
No.
But I'm saying you and I, you got to know where you stand. Because when you and I stand before the judgment seat, it ain't going to have nothing to do with anybody else but us. Mm-hmm. And we have to answer to God for ourselves. Amen. Yes.
What I was going to say was, people will come to you and do things knowing that you are a Christian person and say stuff to you just to see what kind of a rise they can get out of you.
Uh-huh.
And you have to know, like you were just saying, that you know who you believe in and who you confess to know.
Uh-huh.
And no matter what they think of you, I've learned you cannot let people, what they think of you, deter you from your love and your walk with Christ, because
amen,
they will do it.
Amen.
Because they see you as wimps and we don't have the gumption to stand firm on what we
believe. And so that's why we're learning tonight how to declare. And you will declare, I will, amen, stand firm on the Lord. Amen. You'll come to your declaration. You understand what I'm trying to say? My salvation is secure. I'm secure in Christ. Amen. Amen. You got to know. You're going to lose friends. You're going to lose family. You are. Amen. He said the servant is no greater than the master. So if they persecuted him and if they hated him, they're going to hate us too. So we got to know that. I want everybody to love me. I wish I could get everybody to love me. But it's not going to happen. Amen. Now what we have to do, we are charged to love everybody.
That's it.
But everybody's not going to love us.
That's right.
You see what I'm trying to say? That would be nice. You know, everything I do, everybody love me, support me, just do all of those other things. No. It's not going to happen. But if we know who we are in Christ, if we know what the end result is, if we know the goal, you see what I'm trying to say? Where are we going? Amen? What is our ultimate goal? Then that's what matters, because we're going to do what? Like someone said today, we're going to put on blinders. Amen? And we see. I hear. Let's go to, are we ready to go there yet?
To which one?
We're going to go there in just a minute. We'll get in a minute. Another scripture. All right. So let's go to number 5. So declarations can also help us do what? Help us in the time, what? Through temptations and trials.
Okay.
We just talked about that. Being tempted. If you got a declaration, you can declare. You start speaking out loud. The devil is a lie. In the name of Jesus, I'm victorious. I got victory in the name of Jesus. Even the song we sang. You understand what I'm trying to say? I got victory in the name of Jesus. I got victory in this situation in the name of Jesus. I got victory in this situation. Somebody say, Sister Wanda, what you say? That's okay. I got victory in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You can walk around your house and do it. You can walk around your job and do it. You can do, you understand? You got to know that this is a spiritual battle.
Yes.
We got to know that we're in a warfare. It's not the person you see.
Mm-hmm.
It's nothing to do with the people we see.
No.
That we're all, it's just a body. We're the vessel. Amen. Mm-hmm. Do we understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's a spiritual battle.
Yes,
it's not the person you see. It's not the black, the white, the green, the yellow, the this, the that. It's the spirit behind the person. Remember when Peter said to Jesus, you know what I mean? Oh no, Lord, you don't need to go to the cross, blah, blah, blah. And Peter, Jesus had just spoken to him and blessed him. And then he turned around and had to say, get thee behind me. It wasn't Peter. It was the spirit that Peter had yielded himself to make him say that. You see what I'm trying to say? So when we start seeing things in that realm, we won't be seeing individuals as my enemy. You understand? We won't be saying, well, it's you, or it's you, or it's you. No. As we mature in Christ and we learn the promises of God, the declaration of God, we build up our faith in Christ. We're going to be able to say, no, I see this right here. Yeah, this is the lying devil. He's the one that's coming to steal, kill, and to destroy. Yeah, so we got power over that. Amen? When we get into decreeing, we're going to realize we got power over that. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. All right. Helping you through temptations and trials, speaking God's word can help you through them in the midst of the storm. In the midst of the storm, when you're declaring, Sister Pansy, you're declaring God's word in the midst of the storm. When you're on your sick bed, amen?
Yes.
When you're in a car accident, amen?
Yes.
Glory be to God.
Yes,
a lot of people
Jesus.
Throw up their hands and start cussing.
Yes.
You understand?
Mm.
But Sister Wanda, I like to say Jesus.
Yes,
you understand?
Does.
You drive along like this and somebody make them, Jesus. Yeah. So, you know, because you start cussing. But cussing ain't going to help you. You see? Yeah. But when it's in you, do you know what's in you is going to come out?
Yes.
What's in you is going to come out.
You
ever heard somebody say, every time I talk to them, seem like you seem like, you always talking about, you like a walking Bible.
Yeah.
All I hear is the word. Do you ever read anything else but the word? You just got the word. You understand what I'm trying? It's in you. Amen?
You know what they say? I don't want to say this. They say the same thing to me. And do you ever read anything? I say, yes, I read other novels too. And they go, well, I like to read. So I say, I read other, you know, non-biblical novels and stuff. But I say, mine are mostly action-packed or whatever things. But I say, I read that too, but that's not where I am. I don't live in that instant or moment. You know what I mean? It's
Amen.
Just entertainment. And go on.
Yeah.
All right. Number six. Somebody say realignment.
Realignment.
Okay. Helping you realign your mind and heart. It helps us realign our mind and heart. Declaring the biblical verses out loud can help you realign your mind and heart with God's perspective. I might say we got to renew our mind.
Renew it.
Isn't that scripture that say we need to renew our mind?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Which one is that? Is that Romans 12? No, it's not. Is that? There's one that says we need to renew our mind. Renew your mind in Christ. Amen? We need to renew. Is that right?
That's right.
Yeah, and let your behavior be like that of this, and let not your behavior be like that of this world, but be changed and made new in mind, so that by experience you may have knowledge of good and pleasing and complete purpose of God. Amen? So when we are declaring the word of God, it's helping us to do what? Realign. Helping us to do what? Renew. Yeah. Renew our mind.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's why I say. Because after a while where you maybe used to cuss, now Jesus comes out. Mm-hmm. Or glory comes out. Amen? Hallelujah comes out. Yeah. It can happen, folks.
Mm-hmm.
I know we think that it can't, but it can happen. We can renew our mind.
Mm-hmm.
God, you know, Paul would have never said it if it couldn't be done, right?
Mm-hmm.
We have to change the way we think about things. Is that all right?
Yes,
we thought about it one way. Yeah, we have to declare the word of God. Now we're thinking differently. Is that right?
Mm-hmm.
Before, maybe we didn't believe.
That's
but
right.
Now we're saying, oh, no. I know that my God can deliver me. He said, have faith in God. He said, whatsoever you say to this mountain, be thou removed.
Mm-hmm.
Be thou cast into the sea. I'm going to believe it right now. Amen?
Mm-hmm.
Amen. I'm speaking it out loud. Because
mm-hmm.
I'm hearing it. Every time I say it, I hear it in my spirit. It comes in my ear. Amen. I'm saying it. It comes in my ear. Saying it. Amen.
That's right.
Amen. Amen. Now, somebody else can say it. You see, this is one of the things that happen with Christians. The devil knows this, too. He'll have a lot of, you ever notice, even as worship leaders sometimes, we'll try to just exhort or encourage people to just say hallelujah or to say praise God. And you'll notice, and I don't stare at people. But I've been in even my choir when we're singing sometimes.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes you'll see folks, they'll just.
My God.
You know what I'm saying? You know, if I say that as a sign of weakness, I'm not going to open my mouth. There is a scripture, look it up, says, well, the Lord says, what he desires is the fruit of our lips.
That's it.
Mm-hmm.
Anybody know, ever heard that scripture?
Mm-hmm.
What he desires is the fruit of our lips.
Proverbs,
amen? Other words, the fruit. What is the fruit of our lips? For us to open up our mouth and do what? And to bless him. Is that right?
Give him the praise and adoration.
Yes.
That's what Bishop was talking about on the prayer line the other morning from the class we had on Monday. And we were talking about the power that believers have.
Uh-huh.
And he said, what he was asking me about was the way it said, authority gives birth to courage and boldness. So it's like they haven't been reading God's word. They can sit there and just like button their mouth and say, well, I'm not going to do it because somebody told me to say it. Because it says if, as a believer, we get that boldness and courage that we want to step out on God's word. And we want to be a witness.
That, yes,
say,
yes.
I will praise the Lord among the people I was singing unto thee. Wait, that's not the right one.
Yeah, don't.
I thought it said 57. 9.
Yeah, there's one, I think it's in Matthew. It's a New Testament I'm looking for.
Oh, where, not the Old Testament?
Yeah. What Jesus was saying, though, but what he desires is the fruit of your lips.
Yes,
it's in one of the Gospels. The fruit of your lips. Just bless him. Open your mouth and just bless him. He desires to hear the praises of his people. Amen? That's what he desires to hear. That's why he said, what? If we don't praise him, what did he tell them on Palm Sunday? When they said, you know, they were crying Hosanna and Hosanna and blessed be the Lord. Hosanna, blessed be the name of the Lord, one who comes in. He said, what? He said, the man said, well, why are they doing it? He said, well, if they don't do it, the rocks will cry out. You see what I'm trying to say? If they won't open up their mouths and give me praise, the rock's going to cry out and give me praise. You see what I'm saying? So in other words, what he desired? He desired our worship. Why is that? Okay, the angels, they don't have a free will. Anybody know that? Anybody know the angels were not made with a free will? Is that right? So they are around the throne of God, and what are they doing? They are crying, holy, holy, holy. What? The Bible says 24/7, amen? All As right. we read in the book of Revelation, about, that's all they're doing is holy, holy, holy. Holy is the Lord. That's what they're doing. That's their job, amen? But for us, he didn't make us that way. He gave us free will. You understand what I'm trying to say? He said he would that we would, amen, praise him. You understand what I'm trying to say? It's not like he said, I'm going to make you do it. You understand? No, but he desired for us to love him. He desired for us to want to praise him. Amen? He wants us to declare his glory. Amen? He wants us to talk about his goodness. Is that right?
That's right.
Amen. Amen.
Okay, I think I found the one you're talking
about. Amen. That sounds right.
And it says, ye shall know them by their fruits. No, that's not.
No. This.
Isaiah.
Yeah, that's okay. But anyway, you can look that up on your own. But it's saying that God desired the fruit of our lips. He desired for us to open our mouth and to praise him. Amen?
Because I found
Hebrews 13:15.
Yeah, Hebrews, I found.
What does that say?
13:15.
By him, therefore, let us offer the sacrifice of praise to God continually.
Okay,
that
that'll work.
The fruit of our lips, giving thanks to his
name. Okay, okay, there you go. What was that, Hebrews 1?
13:15.
Yeah, okay, that sounds good right there. Hebrews 13:15, yep. So what is the fruit of your lips? What is that?
Offering sacrifices and words, praise and worship unto God.
Hebrews, what scripture was that?
13:15. Yeah, I was going into
Isaiah. Yeah, no, that's good. Yeah, the fruit of our lips, giving witness to his name. So you're blessing him, amen?
Mm-hmm.
Let us then make offerings of praise. What is offerings of praise? What is an offering of praise? Offering of praise to God at all times through him.
Mm-hmm.
That is to say, the fruit of our lips, giving witness to his name. So in other words, how else can we praise? He wants us to open our mouths. Amen? But the enemy fights us on that. So I say, I don't want nobody to hear me. You understand what I'm trying to say? I don't want. But you know, we get to the place where we can get in, and when we move into what you call worship, you know, praise is lifting up God, but when you can get into the place where you just close yourself off with God, where you can be in a crowd. You understand? And you just close yourself off with God. When you can be in a place of desperate need, like the woman with the issue of blood, even though the crowd was stepping up, pushing her back, telling her not to disturb the Lord, she had a desperate need. So she was praising and pushing her way. Amen? Saying, if I can just touch the hem of his garment, I'm not going to let nothing stop me. She was desperate for a move. You see what I'm trying to say? You remember the guy that they told, was it blind Bartimaeus? You remember he heard that Jesus was coming?
Mm-hmm.
You know they tried to tell him what to say, shut up. You understand what I'm trying to say? Be quiet.
Right.
You understand? But what did he do? He was desperate. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. He was desperate for a move. So you know something? The Lord might be saying something to me right now. Maybe the times we need to do is God might have to get us in a place where we're desperate for a move. And then that way we can forget about who's looking at us. We can forget about, you know, who's going to hear us. We can forget about, you know, what somebody's going to say. And we'll be at the place that I'm going to call out on the name of Jesus because I know that I need help. You understand what I'm saying? Because when you know that you need some help, you're going to call out. Why? Why are you going to call out? Because you build up your faith. Why? Because you know God's promises. Why? Because you memorize the word. Why? Because you want to be in alignment with God, where you know he said that he will never leave us nor forsake us. Is that all right? You going through a temptation or a trial. You know that he's your battle axe. You know that he'll fight for you. Is that right? Am I talking right?
That's
amen.
Right.
You say what? No, I'm going to get my mind right. I'm going to realign my mind with the word of God. I know what God can do for me. And then we're going to do what? Do a commitment. Somebody say commitment.
Commitment.
Declarations create a commitment, which create a possibility for yourself in something that you now have to move toward. A commitment. You're looking forward. You're looking forward. Amen. I'm committed to going forward in Christ. Amen. Because I have a vision. He said, without a vision, my people perish. So let's look at Joshua 1:8 real quick. You know, sometimes some people won't even pray until Sister David, they really get in a fix, you know? You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm not going to pray. I'm not going to open my Bible. I'm not going to do anything.
No,
you understand?
Good.
But when we get into a fix, for some reason, we call on the Lord. Is that right?
Yeah.
Well, he wants us to call on him at that time. But how many people know he wants us to not just wait until we get in a fix?
That's right.
That make any sense?
Yeah.
Go ahead and read Joshua 1:8. I got it.
This book of
okay.
the law shall not depart out of thy mouth,
uh-huh.
but thou shalt meditate therein day and night, that thou mayest observe to do according to all that is written therein.
Okay.
For then thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and then thou shalt have good success.
So the way we're going to have good success is by what? Keeping the God promises in our mouth. Is that all right?
Yeah.
Let the book of the law be ever on your lips. On your lips and in your thoughts. Amen? When? Once a week.
Yep. Doing Bible study.
No. Daily.
He said day and night. You better stop. Day and night. So that you may keep with care everything in it. Then a blessing will be on all your way, and you will do well. God is telling us we need to declare his word. He's telling us we need to keep it in our mouths. Okay, one of the best ways to declare is to get a scripture, but you don't have to do that. I got some out. We're just going to repeat a few tonight, and I want to give you one. You can declare you can declare a good place to go if you don't know where to start, and I'm not doing those tonight, but you can go there, is in Deuteronomy. Mm-hmm. You know, go to the book of Deuteronomy. I declare I'm the head and not the tail. Amen?
Okay.
I declare I'm above and not beneath. Is that all right?
Mm-hmm.
Amen? Amen? Mm-hmm. You can start there. You can start there. Anybody know that? What is that? I didn't pull those up, but you can go there. Deuteronomy, is that round about chapter 20, I think it is, somewhere there? And while you're looking for those, go ahead and say this with me. I declare that I'm blessed.
I declare that I'm blessed.
I declare that I'm healed.
I declare that I'm healed.
I declare that I'm prosperous.
I declare that I'm prosperous.
I declare that I am delivered.
I declare that I am delivered.
I declare that I'm successful.
I declare that I am successful.
I declare that I'm victorious.
I declare that I am victorious.
I declare that I'm confident.
I declare that I am confident.
I declare that I'm secure.
I declare that I am secure.
I declare that I'm kind.
I declare that I am kind.
Redeemed.
Redeemed.
Valuable.
Valuable.
Free.
Free.
Somebody say healthy.
Healthy.
Come on, wealthy.
Wealthy.
Wise.
Wise.
Forgiven.
Forgiven.
Anointed.
Anointed.
Accepted.
Accepted.
Approved.
Approved.
Prepared.
Prepared.
Qualified.
Qualified.
Determined.
Determined.
Patient.
Patient.
Equipped.
Equipped.
Empowered.
Empowered.
Well able.
Well able.
I'm a child of the Most High God.
Child.
I mean, you can go on and on and on. Do you see what I'm saying there now? Mm-hmm. Amen. Amen. I knew it was 20 something. Go there real quick. Deuteronomy 28.
And 13.
Yes, yes. Go there. Go there. And sister, if you see one, go ahead and say it.
He said, the Lord will make you the head, not the tail.
So I need you to declare those now. Mm-hmm. I need you to look in there and see it and declare it. Just go ahead and say it.
Mm-hmm. I declare I am the head, not the tail.
That's exactly right. And another thing that is going to go with the declaration. I love you and I love your gentle spirit. But there comes a time when you're going to need to put your foot down. Mm-hmm. There comes a time when you're going to need to stand firm. You see what I'm trying to say? Mm-hmm. In other words, what are we declaring again? We're declaring against the enemy. This is a warfare. Mm-hmm. Somebody say warfare. Mm-hmm. Amen? Mm-hmm. Now, am I telling you to go, no, what I'm saying is we might have to say, I declare that I'm the head and not tail. It depends on, look up here. It depends on what you're being tempted by. Mm-hmm. It depends on what trial you're in. Mm-hmm. Sometimes you're gonna have to say it. Mm-hmm. You're gonna have to say it, Sister Pansy, and mean it. Amen. If something is trying to take over your house, mm-hmm. something's trying to come against you and your family, mm-hmm. you got to declare it. You understand what I'm trying to say? Mm-hmm. You got to, because the devil ain't, listen. He won't believe you. You know what I'm saying? He's like, what are you talking about? But you're going to declare it where? In the name of Jesus. As we come next week and we talk about decree, you got the authority. Amen. He's giving you the authority. But you got to know it. Yes. You got to know it. Yes, we're going to close. Remember the seven sons of Sceva? Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. They came. They were declaring something. Yeah. And the God whom Paul knows. The one that whom Paul preaches. You understand? Yeah. But we got to understand something. When we read in the scriptures, the Bible says when the devils hear the name of Jesus, they tremble. Mm-hmm. Man is the only one that don't tremble at that. Mm-hmm. Because they know the power of God. Mm-hmm. They know the power of God. They know who he is. Mm-hmm. They know who he is. You understand? Mm-hmm. But we don't. Mm-hmm. See? So when we come to know the power that we have in him, amen? Mm-hmm. Then we stand in that name and that authority. Now, with Paul, they had to yield to Paul because Paul knew who he was. Mm-hmm. He knew the power of God. He knew the power of Jesus. Mm-hmm. But they're talking about how come it, and then the one that whom Paul knew. They said, no. Paul we know and Jesus we know. Well, who are you? And they're causing some trouble. So we got to know that. Go ahead, sis.
I was going to say, not only knowing the word of God, we have to obey it.
Yes.
And that's what, and everywhere I, scripture you had to read so far when we went, I right next to it, I got obey.
Yes.
Obey.
All of them. That's everything.
Obey.
Faith and obedience.
You can't get away from it when the Bible says, when what he say, faith without works is dead, but you got to obey the work that he's telling you to do. Yes. Amen? Mm-hmm. So exactly right. You can't get away from it. Just obey. You got to know it, and you got to do it. Obey. Amen? Mm-hmm. Amen. Was this good tonight?
Yeah,
it was good. So I gave you some declarations, but I want you to get your own. When you come back next week, you'll have some declarations of your own. You don't have to have as many as I gave here, but find something. Get you a scripture or something that you want to declare over your life. You want to declare it over your family. Amen? Mm-hmm. Declare it over your body. Mm-hmm. And it's not just saying it once. I got my thing on my wall in my bathroom. I declare good health. Mm-hmm. You understand what I'm trying to say? Mm-hmm. I declare. Yeah, I got some things written up there. Yeah. We got to do that. Amen? Mm-hmm. All right, we're going to pray. We got to go.
Go ahead. You can press that button. I do that still because I know the Lord is cleaning me up from the inside out.
Uh-huh.
Like I said, I messed myself up. But he is cleaning me up. And then it came to me. I was listening to a minister talking. We were talking about, like, with Hezekiah.
Uh-huh.
Hezekiah, the Lord said, you're going to die.
Uh-huh.
Get your house in order.
Yes.
You're going to die.
Yes.
Hezekiah did that heartfelt prayer.
Yes.
And the Lord turned it
yes.
around.
Yes. Gave him 15 more years.
About the signs of seeing things.
Uh-huh.
Hezekiah wanted a sign.
Uh-huh.
To know that not only was he hearing
uh-huh.
what the Lord had said and he's going to live.
Uh-huh.
But what would the sign be?
Uh-huh.
And he turned back time. He talked uh-huh. about what he called daylight saving time.
Yeah.
Backed
yeah.
it up.
Uh-huh.
10 degrees.
Uh-huh.
And I'm laughing because I'm getting, I say, Lord, you cleaning me up.
Uh-huh.
And I asked you for a financial blessing years ago. And it had bring back to my memory, not only, you're not just praying to God to heal you,
uh-huh.
but you would want to be healed to be a blessing to someone else.
Yes.
Hezekiah had to go to war
yes.
for the city
uh-huh.
in which he lived.
Uh-huh.
And I've been praying about this city.
Uh-huh.
So whatever the Lord raised me up to do in this city,
amen.
It's not just for me.
Amen. Amen.
Keep reminding myself.
Nothing we go through is just for us. It's always a blessing to somebody else. We are over time. It was a blessing tonight. Let's give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Thank God for Jesus. Thank God for the word.
Amen.
Amen. Thank God for social media.
Amen.
Guys, give us some comments out there. Let us know, you know, some questions, some comments, whatever you have. Amen. Send them in. Send them in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. God bless you. God bless you. Guys, Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you tonight. We bless you. We praise you. We magnify you. We give you glory. We give you honor. We give you praise. Thank you, Lord God. Help us, Lord, to grab hold to this tonight. It'll be a life-changing for us, Lord, that as we start to declare your word over our lives, over our bodies, over our home, over our jobs, over everything that pertains to us. Oh, God, in the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. We thank you, Lord. We know that you honor your word. And not only do you hear prayer, but you answer. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. God bless you all. All right, we're getting ready to give so we can do our Cash App. Ark of Jesus, amen.
Dollar sign,
Cash App, dollar sign, Ark of Jesus. And we can also do Givelify, Ark of Jesus Ministries, is it? Givelify is Ark of Jesus Ministries. All right. And make sure, guys, join us on the prayer line. Come on, Sister Wanda, this is your number. What's the prayer line? Go for it. Get the prayer line number, shout it out.
1-267.
Okay, 267.
Seven.
Say it again, loud so they can hear you.
1-267-807-9611.
Okay.
Access code 178-408.
Amen. That's at 6 a.m. Monday through Friday and I think Saturday as well. All right? Exactly. We will see you next time right here. Next week it is decree in the name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen.